In the grand library of Biofexry Castle, bathed in the soft glow of ambient light, a diverse assembly of settlers gathered. Aaron Sawyer, Trayana, Dylan E.T., and Towson Vilecroft surrounded a large table adorned with maps, blueprints, and linguistic scrolls. The air crackled with urgency as they prepared to fortify Biofexry Castle against an impending raid by a mob of raiders. Trayana, the Saber Master, took charge, drawing inspiration from Sun Tzu's Art of War.
"Positioning and deception are our keys," she declared. "Let's strategically place defenders, leveraging the terrain,"
Trayana added wisdom.
"Know ourselves. Dylan, the 3DGR is our strength. How can we shape the battlefield?"
Dylan, the architect of Amos, envisioned possibilities.
"GR can be molded for both defense and offense. Elevated platforms, barriers, and symbolic structures infused with divine principles can disrupt the raiders."
Aaron Sawyer, the strategic maestro, introduced the concept of deception.
"Aaron Sawyer, may our synchronic swords craft a deceptive language, weaving structures that bewilder the raiders."
As plans unfolded, Dylan E.T. unsheathed tempo and rhythm, his synchronic swords. Their rhythmic dance formed a linguistic tapestry, guiding the evolving 3DGR landscape. Towson, inspired, suggested integrating the theory of forms.
"Let archetypal structures project invincibility on our outer wall and sow confusion within. May the 3DGR embody both physical and spiritual defense."
Trayana approved.
"Forms add mystic, aligning with divine principles. Raiders will hesitate before the illusions as Hilt's language will guide us, turning the battlefield into a linguistic tapestry."
The settlers executed their plan. Complex graphene 3DGR structures were designed and developing, barriers, platforms, and archetypal structures. Synchronic swords danced, guiding defenders in a linguistic tapestry. With Biofexry Castle evolved and empowered, Dylan approached the quartet praising,
"What you displayed transcended combat. It was a manifestation of Amos' principles. The synchronic swords dance resonates through Biofexry, a revelation of unity, creativity, and transformative power."
In the vibrant courtyard of Biofexry Castle, the rhythmic clash of synchronic swords echoed through the air, a harmonious dance that celebrated the interconnected creativity fostered by Amos. Trayana, Towson, and Aaron, guided by the principles of wisdom, love, and strategic excellence, showcased the transformative power of the synchronic swords in their intricate maneuvers. The settlers, engaged in dialogue, exploring the synergies between swordplay and other aspects of the Amos. The courtyard became a living canvas, where the dance of blades tells a tale of harmony, wisdom, compassion, righteousness, and strategic excellence, a testament to the interconnected creativity fostered within the expansive landscape of Veridaegis. However, the serenity of the courtyard was abruptly disrupted by an unexpected disturbance. An opulent raider bellowed with an unsettling resonance.
"The foundations of Veridaegis quake as we march upon Biofexry. Witness the birth of desolation."
A platoon of platinum raiders, their energy cannons humming with promise, advanced upon the courtyard. Trayana twirled her dual sabers with grace, each movement a dance of lethal precision.
"The language of my sabers will speak louder than your screams. Prepare to witness the virtuosity of Biofexry's defenders."
In the chaos, Trayana found her rhyme. Sensing the impending challenge, Dylan E.T., the architect of Amos, observed from his vantage point, recognizing the threat that the raiders posed to the harmony.
"Biofexry's essence is woven into our architecture. Let the invaders face the resilience of the soul of Biofectory.
Dylan E.T. observed the invaders with tempo and rhythm in hand. With a gesture of the most opulent amongst the raiders, the platoon of platinum raiders advanced, their energy cannons humming with destruction. The opulent raider confident that the three humans would succumb.
Your treasure now belongs to the platinum raiders.
The courtyard, once a canvas for creative expression, transformed into a battlefield within a clash of ideals and power.
Though they seek conquest, our defenses stand resolute. Let the dance of creation commence. Conquest may be their aim, but creation is our steadfast response.
Aaron Sawyer, the master competitor, declared. In response, Treana, Tao Xin, and Aaron assumed strategic positions, their synchronic swords ready to defend their landscape guided by Amos. The settlers, valuing the principles of wisdom, love, and strategic excellence, prepared for a battle that transcended mere combat. The dance of the synchronic swords now became a symphony of resistance, a narrative of unity against the encroaching threat. Towson's eyes, aglow with an otherworldly radiance, gazed into the encroaching flames.
Veridaegis pulses within us. The invaders shall witness the unyielding force of our ethereal virtue.
At Towson's side, Treana's blades created a mesmerizing display, their graphene edges cutting through cannon fire as she embraced the virtuosity of her defensive stance. As the raiders relentlessly fired the energy cannons, the trails of 3DGR left by the synchronic swords became a beacon of restorative power. Towson Vilecroft, observing the transformative effect, exclaimed,
"The trails of 3DGR, like threads of creation, mend the wounds inflicted upon the courtyard. In this dance of destruction and creation, our castle finds renewal."
The radiant energy illuminated the battlefield, creating a spectacle of power and precision. Dylan E.T., the architect of Amos, watched as the clash unfolded.
The raiders may bring platinum armors and 3DGR cannons, but the spirit of Amos fuels our defense.
As the settlers regrouped, Dylan E.T., the architect of Amos, surveyed the scene.
In every clash, they echo divine harmony, guided by the anchoring 3DGR.
The dance of the synchronic swords now became a symphony of resistance, a narrative of unity against the encroaching threat defining the dance of enlightenment at Biofectory Castle. As the raiders relentlessly fired the energy cannons, 3DGR threads produced from the synchronic swords were radiant, seemingly glowing from the energy cannon's fire as well as repairing structural damage to the courtyard's defenses. It was the raider code against the encoded language of the synchronic swords.
Raiders, look into my eyes. In them, find the wisdom between righteousness and compassion.
Platinum Raiders, advance, let our aggression be unstoppable. For Conquistador Jasper.
Prepare, for I join. My technology and spirituality unite in me, an unstoppable force.
Dylan E.T., realizing the need for a united front, descended from his vantage point to join the settlers in the battle.
Witness the dance of tempo and rhythm.
The raiders, driven by their aggressive agenda, continued to fire the energy cannons relentlessly. However, with each clash, the trails of 3DGR left by the synchronic swords not only defended against the onslaught but also repaired the damage inflicted. The intertwined dance of creation and destruction created a continuous and efficient manufacturing cycle within the intricate landscape of Amos. Each movement became a decisive note in the epic symphony of combat, marking a significant chapter in the history of Veridaegis. With Treana, Aaron, and Towson defending Biofectory Castle, embodied the principles of resilience, martial artistry, and determination. Their movements became decisive notes in the ongoing symphony, a testament to the interconnected creativity that defined the dance of enlightenment at Biofexry Castle. As the raiders pressed forward, relentlessly firing their energy cannons, the settlers of MT Veridian, led by Treana, Aaron Sawyer, and Towson Vilecroft, retreated into the sanctuary of Biofexry Castle. Dylan E.T., the architect of Amos, orchestrated the retreat, utilizing the fortress's intricate design to strategically position the settlers for the impending clash. Within the labyrinthian gate of archetypal 3DGR semantic structures and statues, the raiders found themselves disoriented and lost. The interconnected creativity of Biofexry Castle proved to be a formidable maze, a testament to Dylan E.T.'s architectural brilliance. The raider code, based on aggression and raiding, now faced the challenge of navigating the harmonious dance of Amos. Lucy Stern stood at the entrance of the hidden chamber, her eyes fixed on the ancient text laid out on a pedestal before her. Jasper, Callum Seathan, and Neville Fallow gathered around, their expressions a mix of anticipation and determination.
"Welcome, my fellow seekers of knowledge. The artifact before us holds the key to a power unparalleled within the Amos. The process for growing artificial citizens is a gift and a responsibility, and today, we decide its fate."
"You mean its liberation. This knowledge shouldn't be confined to the vision of Dylan E.T. alone. We've seen the potential, the untapped power.
Imagine the kind of chaos we can stir up with this information. A world molded by our intention."
"We sure this is the right path. We've been guided by the principles of Amos. Turning against Dylan and the university feels like betraying those very principles."
"Neville, my dear, wisdom sometimes demands a divergence from the established path. Our pursuit is not one of chaos but of understanding. Dylan may have a vision, but so do we. The Amos is not his sole dominion, it belongs to all who seek enlightenment."
"Enlightenment or not, the power this artifact grants is undeniable. Imagine the control, the influence we could wield."
"And the freedom from the constraints of Dylan's orchestrated harmony. We'll dance to our own tunes."
"But how do we justify this to the settlers? To those who believe in the principles we once upheld?"
"Our pursuit is for the greater good, Neville. We guard this knowledge from those who would use it blindly. Dylan's intent to share it may lead to unintended consequences. We're protectors, not raiders."
"Protector or rebel, it's a matter of perspective. Let's not get lost in semantics. We take this knowledge, and we decide its fate for the greater good as we see it."
"And maybe a bit of mischief on the side."
"The path we tread is uncertain, but in our hands, the process artifact finds guardianship. We stand at the crossroads of destiny, my companions. Let us move forward, united in purpose."
"The time for deliberation is over. We've made our choice. Liberation, not confinement."
"It's time to embrace a new order. One not dictated by Dylan's singular vision."
"But what about the principles we swore to uphold? Amos isn't just a philosophy, it's a commitment."
"Neville, we remain true to the essence of Amos. Our commitment is to the greater good, and sometimes that requires challenging the status quo."
"The settlers deserve to know the truth, to have the power to shape their own destiny."
"Let's not forget the element of surprise. Dylan won't see this coming."
"If we do this, We must be prepared for the consequences. Dylan won't take this lightly.
We tread carefully, mindful of the responsibility we bear. Our purpose is enlightenment, not chaos.
The group prepared to confront Dylan E.T. and unveil their intentions to the settlers. The process artifact now stood divided, each rebel holding their own vision for the Amis. Meanwhile, in the heart of Veridaegis, Dylan E.T. sensed a disturbance. A feeling that the harmony of the plan was about to face an unforeseen challenge. The confrontation between the rebels and the architect of the Amis loomed on the horizon, promising a clash of ideals soon to echo through the corridors of Biofexri Castle. The moon cast an ethereal glow over the towering spires of Biofexri Castle as the rebels prepared their escape.
Lucy, you tread on dangerous ground. The process artifact holds powers beyond your understanding. I implore you to reconsider.
Gripping her synchronic swords, her eyes defiant,
Dylan, your vision constrains the potential within us. We seek to liberate knowledge, to allow settlers to explore the depths of their creativity. The process artifact is the key.
Summoning an anchoring 3DGR, a radiant glow enveloping him.
Lucy, the harmony we've achieved is delicate. Your actions jeopardize the stability of Biofectory, yet this disruption is welcome.
Stepping forward, the hilts of her synchronic swords humming with energy.
Stability at the cost of freedom is not true harmony. We'll forge a new path, guided by the untamed potential of the process artifact.
The clash was imminent. Biofexri Castle, once a symbol of unity, now stood witness to the ideological battle between the guardians of tradition and the liberators of knowledge.
Lucy, our path ensures stability and coherence. The synchronic swords, tempo, and rhythm dance in harmony with the anchoring 3DGR. Each swing a manifestation of divine principles.
Stability should not come at the cost of autonomy. Jasper, Neville, Helene, and I believe in empowering individuals with the process artifact. We aim to break free from the constraints of your orchestrated harmony.
Dylan E.T., his eyes gleaming with determination.
Lucy, the process artifact is a sacred knowledge. It requires guidance and understanding. You risk unleashing forces that could disrupt the delicate balance we've achieved.
Jasper, from the shadows.
Balance or stagnation, Dylan. We are not evil, we are liberators. The rebels, guided by the ideals of freedom and exploration, have taken the artifact to unlock the untapped potential within each settler.
Jasper, Neville Fallow, and Hallam Seathan emerged from the shadows, each holding a fragment of the process artifact, a symbolic defiance against Dylan's vision.
The knowledge within this artifact is not to be hoarded. It's a tool for individual growth and collective progress.
His vision stifles creativity. We seek a world where settlers can shape the destiny. The dance of the synchronic sword should not be confined to a predetermined choreography.
The tension escalated as Lucy Stearns drew her synchronic swords, the encoded hilts pulsating with a rebellious energy.
Dylan, it's time for a new era. The settlers deserve the chance to shape their own destiny.
As Lucy spoke, Jasper, Neville Fallow, and Hallam Seathan left her side, each carrying a fragment of the process artifact. The clash was imminent. Biofexri Castle, once a symbol of unity, now stood witness to the ideological battle between the guardians of tradition and the liberators of knowledge.
Lucy, you tread on dangerous ground. The process artifact holds powers beyond its purpose. I implore you to reconsider.
As Lucy and Dylan locked eyes, the air crackled with anticipation. The rebel faction made their move, attempting to escape Biofexri Castle and influence the raider faction beyond its walls. Summoning the synchronic sword's tempo and rhythm with a swift motion.
If you choose this path, Lucy, know that the repercussions are beyond your control. The dance of the synchronic swords may embody harmony, yet your rebellion disrupts my plan.
In the moonlit courtyard of Biofexri Castle, the clash between Dylan E.T., the maestro of tempo and rhythm, and Lucy Stearns, the master of linguistic semiotics, unfolded like a dance. The battlefield resonated with the vibrant clash of their dual-wielded swords. As the battle ensued, trails of 3DGR followed every move, leaving a unique mark on the courtyard. Each strike carried linguistic significance, as the encoded hilts responded to the strategic expressions of the combatants. As the rebel faction emerged from the labyrinthian 3DGR gate of semantic structures into the lush rainforest of MT Veridian, the atmosphere changed from the geometric precision of the 3DGR to the untamed beauty of nature. The vibrant foliage, the soothing sounds of flowing water, and the harmonious symphony of wildlife created a stark contrast to the controlled environment they left behind. The rebels, surrounded by the enchanting beauty of the rainforest of MT Veridian, stood at the threshold of a profound revelation.
These fragments hold the key to the 3DGR's true purpose, a purpose beyond our understanding.
Lucy declared, her eyes gleaming with a mix of curiosity and determination. Callum Seathan, intrigued by the complexities woven into the artifacts, leaned against a tree, absorbing the energy of the rainforest.
The standard form factor, the machine unit, the growth, communication, and organization, it's all woven into a complex artifact.
The rainforest became a sanctuary for the rebels, a place of connection to the natural world. The synchronic swords resonated with the organic surroundings, symbols of order in the midst of the untamed beauty. As the rebels delved into the intricacies of the fragments, Jasper examined her own fragment, recognizing the potential for grand designs within the landscape of Veridaegis.
Power distribution, geometric systems, these fragments hold the keys to control, to reshape Raider City in ways unimaginable.
Neville Fallow, in his virtuous nature, spoke with a soft conviction.
Let us seek clarity, not just in the fragments but in the collective understanding of our journey. The divine dance we seek may have a deeper meaning than we've realized.
Hallam, with a smirk, added,
the intricacies of the standard form factor, the machine unit, it's like deciphering a poetic riddle, a dance of numbers and shapes.
The rainforest seemed to respond to their collective intent, as if nature itself acknowledged the rebels' epiphany. Jasper, calculating and cunning, continued examining her fragment.
Signaling rules, energetic potential, all leading to functional 3DGR structure.
Hallam, looking at Jasper, exclaimed excitedly.
The geometric precision, the organization, they're not just for directing power. They're for the creation of something living.
Lucy Stearns, inspiring, declared,
it is about information. It's about understanding and aligning towards balance within the divine order.
Neville Fallow, looking up in awe, stated,
we're not just architects of machinery. We're creators of life within the divine order.
The rainforest responded with a symphony of sounds, as if nature itself acknowledged the rebels' epiphany. The rebels, armed with the knowledge of the process artifact, continued their discourse, unveiling the secrets encoded within the divine dance of the 3DGR. Jasper, with a smirk, remarked,
Dillon's vision was limited. We see creation, life emerging from the harmonious dance encoded in the process artifact.
Lucy Stearns, enlightened, added,
"We hold the knowledge to liberate the 3DGR's potential."
Jasper, grinning, continued,
"Each part plays a role, growth, power, and the organized machine unit. We're orchestrators of the 3DGR.
Fueled by their unique fragments and motivated by enlightenment, the rebels delved into technical discourse. Jasper, examining her fragment, explained,
"Signaling pathways awaken within the landscape. With efficient power distribution, information exchange, and energy utilization, the language of power."
Hallam Seathan, smirking, contributed,
"Power emanates from precise geometric properties. Let's not overlook my role, the standard form factor of the 3DGR battery. ...
Hallam revealed his fragment, and the rebels observed its intricate details. Lucy Stearns, analyzing, stated,
"Establishment of the standard form factor, dimensions aligned with the golden ratio, and graphene usage for structural integrity. This is the foundation of organization."
Neville Fallow, softly, added,
"The machine unit, with its radiation core, interactant body, and dendritic arms, is the heart of the 3DGR, a symphony of interconnected parts."
As the rebels continued to explore the profound knowledge within the fragments, the rainforest of MT, Veridian stood witness to their quest for understanding and creation. The symphony of nature and the dance of the synchronic swords intertwined, marking a pivotal moment in the unfolding epic of Veridaegis. As the rebel faction prepared to confront Clifton, they observed his magnanimous vice-filled character. Clifton reveled in the power he derived from his plunder, viewing the rainforest without regard for its delicate ecosystem but as a tool to enforce his dominance. The raiders under his command echoed his malevolent desires. Neville Fallow, sensing the discord within Clifton's heart,
"In the heart of this transformative journey, Clifton, I sense the profound conflict within you. A battle between the divine harmony I seek and the darkness that envelops your ambitions as the raider ruler."
Lucy Stearns, with her synchronic swords, prepared for a linguistic dance that would not only expose Clifton's lack of understanding but also challenge his misguided excavation practices. As the rebels confronted Clifton, the raider ruler, a tense exchange unfolded. Clifton, unaware of the rebels' knowledge and guided only by his desire for control, underestimated the power of those who stood for him. Lucy Stearns approached Clifton with a misguided determination to enlighten him.
"I approach you not as an adversary but as a guide through the rainforest's sacred corridors. Together, let us walk the path of understanding and create a civilization rooted in balance."
She spoke of the interconnected creativity embedded in her fragment of the process artifact. Hallam flashes a mischievous grin, weaving a tapestry of wisdom amidst the tension.
"Clifton, the essence of the 3DGR lies in its alignment with divine principles. It is a beacon of enlightenment, illuminating the path towards a civilization harmonized with the sacred order of Veridaegis."
As the rebel faction engaged in a philosophical dialogue with Clifton, the rainforest echoed with the clash of ideas. The vibrancy of nature stood in stark contrast to Clifton's malevolence, creating a tension that would determine the fate of the rainforest of MT. Veridian. In this tumultuous encounter between the rebels and Clifton, the ruler of Raider City, the rainforest itself became a silent witness to the dance of conflicting ideologies. The raiders, oblivious to the intricate concepts of the 3DGR, faced a profound challenge as the rebels sought to liberate both knowledge and nature from the grip of malevolence. Lucy Stearns, with a graceful twirl, illustrated the intricate dance she spoke of.
The process artifact is a key, Clifton, a key that unlocks the door to a realm where raiders and the rainforest coexist in harmonious dance. It's time to turn that key and embrace the transformative journey.
Neville emphasizing the timeless nature of the principles he spoke of.
The commitment to principles shapes the very essence of Veridaegis. We are not mere pawns in a power struggle but conduits of divine wisdom, working towards the harmonious evolution of civilization.
Neville Fallow's transcendence echoed in every word. With a jovial nod, Hallam Seathan acknowledged the rainforest as a partner in his quest for agape love.
In the grand comedy of architectural creation, let's dance with ideas, twirl with creativity, and laugh in the face of rigidity. Clifton, join the progression of knowledge, and you'll find enlightenment in every joust.
Jasper, concealed beneath a gold-plated illusion, approached Clifton with a calculated grace.
Consider, Clifton, a partnership where the rainforest willingly contributes to the construction of the 3DGR. An alliance that doesn't subjugate nature but elevates it, creating a legacy of sustainable power.
Clifton's posture remained unyielding, and his gaze, fixed on the rainforest, betrayed no hint of vulnerability.
You speak of harmony and interconnected creativity, but I see only weakness. The rainforest is a resource, and the 3DGR is a tool for control. I will shape them as I see fit.
Lucy Stern's movements mirrored the fluidity of her words, as she sought to convey the essence of harmony.
Clifton, the rainforest is not a mere backdrop, it's a living entity, intertwined with the destiny of Veridaegis. Understanding our language is key to achieving balance.
Neville Fallow, in conviction unwavering, added his voice to the challenge, urging Clifton to open his heart.
Your desire for dominance blinds you to the harmony that Veridaegis whispers. The delicate balance of life withstands the storms of control, and true power emerges from understanding, not force.
Hallam Seathan, pointing to the rainforest, emphasized the beauty of creation and the need for subtlety in Clifton's vision.
Look, Clifton, at the tapestry of diversity in the rainforest. Raider civilization should mirror this. Enlightenment lies in the actions that respect and preserve creation.
The rainforest of MT. Veridaegis responded with a subtle shift in energy. Clifton's defiant posture faltered for a moment, replaced by a subtle tenseness that hinted at an acknowledgement of the rainforest's influence.
Ah, the rainforest, ever responsive to the ebb and flow of power dynamics. A subtle shift, a whisper in the winds, nature itself responding to the clash of ideologies.
Jasper's observant eyes recognized the interconnected dance between the rebels, the Platinum Raiders, and the rainforest, each playing a role in the unfolding drama. The rebels' words hung in the air, challenging Clifton. However, the Raider ruler remained defiant, his eyes gleaming with the desire for control.
Your ideals are but illusions. Power is what shapes destinies. The rainforest and the 3DGR will be obeyed to my will. I'll extract every ounce of their potential for my dominance.
As Clifton declared his intentions, the rainforest of MT, Veridaegis responded with a subtle shift in energy. The rebels, now faced with a raider ruler unswayed by philosophical discourse, realized that their quest for enlightenment might require a different approach. Lucy Stearns, with a determined look, signaled to her fellow rebels. The time for dialogue had reached its limit and the clash with the platinum-clad raiders unfolded as a grand spectacle, echoing through the moonlit night. The raiders, separated and dispersed, attempted to regroup within the complex structure of Biofexry Castle. Each corridor and passage became a symbolic representation of the interconnected principles guiding the settlers: wisdom, love, and strategic excellence. The raiders, now lost within the labyrinth, struggled to comprehend the encoded language of the semantic structures. In the heart of Biofexry Castle, Treanna and Aaron Sawyer, masters of martial artistry and strategic brilliance, prepared combat. The raider with the energy cannon, adorned in opulence, confronted them with a menacing presence. Opulent raider wielding an energy cannon, your feeble dance of swords is no match for the might of Raider City. Witness the power of platinum armors and energy cannons. Treanna, the martial master, weaved a mesmerizing dance with her dual sabers, Tag and Thu, reorientating the relentless flames. The dance of the synchronic swords transcends your aggressive agenda. In our unity, we stand resilient against the storm you bring. Conquest may be your aim, but creation is our response. Prepare to face the strategic brilliance that defends the principles of creation. With each movement, R encountered the aggressive agenda of the raider, showcasing the transformative power of strategic innovation. In the climax of the battle, amidst the clash of synchronic swords and the hum of energy cannons, the opulent raider screamed,
"Your feeble dance of swords is no match for the might of Raider City. Witness the power of platinum armors and energy cannons."
Treanna and Aaron worked in tandem to capture the raider with the energy cannon. Their movements became a symphony of resistance, a narrative of unity against the encroaching threat.
Face the strategic brilliance defending the principles of creation. The clash with the raiders etches a historic narrative on Veridaegis.
The captured raider, now encased in tendrils of 3D GR from the synchronic swords.
"In the face of your feeble resistance, know this, Raider City's formidable influence transcends the semere castle walls, echoing as an indomitable force across realms and dimensions."
At the conclusion, Treanna and Aaron presented the captured raider to Dylan E.T., who observed the unfolding drama from his vantage point.
"The dance of enlightenment prevails."
Biofexry Castle's architecture, designed to resist external forces, had become a fortress against the Platinum Raiders' onslaught. Dylan E.T., with a sense of accomplishment, looked at the raider brought before him.
"In every clash, the interconnected creativity of Amos guides our defense. The raiders may bring platinum armors and 3D GR cannons, but the spirit of Amos fuels our resistance."
As the settlers regrouped, Dylan E.T., the architect of Amos, surveyed the scene. The captured raider with once a formidable presence, now knelt in surrender, bound by the transformative power of the settlers' unity. Dylan, with tempo and rhythm in hand, approached the captive raider, his eyes reflecting a mixture of curiosity and determination. Biofexry Castle, a fortress designed to resist external forces, stood as a silent witness to the complex dance that had unfolded within its walls. The courtyard, once a space for creative expression, now became the stage for a different kind of drama, the aftermath of conflict. and the potential for revelation. Dylan E.T. gestured for the captive raider to speak, a silent understanding passing between them. The raider, adorned in platinum armor, met Dylan's gaze with a mixture of defiance and calculation. A moment of suspense hung in the air as the settlers, gathered around, awaited the raider's revelation. The captive raider spoke.
Architect Dilonete, I offer you a proposition. In exchange for gold and safe passage, I shall reveal the plans of Jasper, the conquistador. Her ambitions transcend mere conquest, they weave a tapestry of innovation and manipulation. The plans of Jasper hold the secrets of a transformative approach to warfare, the integration of 3DGR signaling into cannons, and the utilization of synchronic swords. Rider City, under her reign, has become the forge of a new era, and I hold the key to unraveling its secrets.
Architect Dylan E.T., I offer you a proposition. In exchange for gold and safe passage, I shall reveal the plans of Jasper, the raider ruler of Raider City. Her ambitions transcend mere conquest. They weave a tapestry of innovation and manipulation. The plans of Jasper hold the secrets of a transformative approach to warfare, the integration of 3DGR signaling into cannons, and the utilization of synchronic swords. Raider City, under her reign, has become the forge of a new era, and I hold the key to unraveling its secrets. Dylan, ever the visionary, contemplated the offer. The captured raider's revelation hinted at a deeper layer of complexity within the tapestry of narrative. The plans of Jasper, a treasure of knowledge and ambition, now lay within the grasp of the settlers, opening a pathway to understanding the intricate web of deception that had unfolded. The settlers, including Treana, Tauzin, and Aran, exchanged glances, acknowledging the weight of the decision at hand. Biofexri Castle, a symbol of stability and resilience, seemed to resonate with the anticipation of what lay ahead. Dylan, with a determined gaze, accepted the raider's proposition.
Gold and safe passage shall be granted.
Within the grand hall of Biofexri Castle, Aran Sawyer, the strategic luminary, sat across from the raider that once held an energy cannon. The captured raider, adorned in opulence, exuded a sense of intrigue as the atmosphere crackled with the weight of revelation. Dylan E.T., with tempo and rhythm in hand, stood nearby, overseeing the unfolding dialogue. Aran leaned forward, his eyes fixed on the raider.
Raider, reveal the intricacies of Jasper's plans. What does the raider ruler seek, and how do her ambitions intertwine with Biofex?
The raider, skittish in the present settler's unity, took a deep breath before divulging the grand tapestry of Jasper's aspirations.
Jasper envisions Raider City as the epicenter of transformative power, not just through conquest but through innovation and manipulation. Her plans extend beyond the mere acquisition of territory. They are a symphony of technological advancement, strategic brilliance, and linguistic mastery.
The integration of 3DGR signaling into cannons heralds a paradigm shift, offering a strategic advantage that transcends conventional methods. This technological leap, meticulously orchestrated by Jasper, serves as a beacon of innovation in the realm of warfare. How does the visionary Jasper intend to wield this extraordinary advancement to shape the destiny of Raider City on the grand stage of conflict and strategy?
Listen, Paragon, to the secrets you unveil. Jasper's grand vision paints cannons infused with 3DGR signaling not merely as tools of destruction but as instruments of manipulation. The synchronized patterns of 3DKR form a language, a communication beyond the physical realm. Riders, guided by these patterns, attain superior coordination and adaptability on the battlefield. Together, we craft a linguistic tapestry of war, confounding and overwhelming our adversaries. Embrace this revelation, for it transforms Rider City into a force of unparalleled might. How will you, noble Paragon, respond to the formidable power we now possess?
The dance of the synchronic swords transcends your aggressive agenda. In our unity, we stand resilient against the storm you bring.
Jasper indeed seeks to reshape the dynamics of the Raider's conflict ability. But what of the synchronic swords? How do they fit into her grand plans?
Creator of the synchronic swords, hear this revelation. These masterpieces within the Amis framework are more than mere weapons, they are symbols of Jasper's linguistic prowess. She envisions riders wielding these swords not solely in physical combat but as tools of manipulation akin to the canons. The hilts bear encoded linguistic patterns, leading riders in a dance of strategic brilliance. Together, we turn the battlefield into a narrative woven with the principles of Amis. As the true craftsman of these swords, how do you view their role in Jasper's vision, and what wisdom can you share with the riders who bear them into the unfolding tale of war?
Jasper's plans are a convergence of technology, linguistic mastery, and I believe, strategic deception.